What is up, you guys? It's your boy Jonathan here, but you can call me Yanni. Today's gonna be an awesome day. We're going to the Breakout Music Festival where I have a media pass. So we're gonna go in, we're gonna do a lot of fun things, man. I'm gonna show you guys all the behind the scenes footage. We're gonna do some cool ass interviews. Hopefully we get to meet some awesome like celebrities and like some musicians. I really wanna meet Ski Mask, the Slump God, and Juice Wrld. So I think actually only Juice Wrld today. I think Ski Mask might be tomorrow. But I'm such a big fan of Juice Wrld, man. Like, his album was just like one of the best albums I heard all year so far. And so I'm a really big fan of his and I want to see him. But yeah, we're going there right now. We're gonna go in, walk in, and just get some amazing footage. Come along with me as we go into the Breakout Music Festival. This is the place to be this summer, man. Breakout Festival, it's like, it's so sick. Like, it's all the best artists that you could ever want. You know, Faded, honestly, can't compete with this. I mean, I fuck with Faded. Like, if you guys want to give me media pass there too, let's go. But like, that's where we're headed right now. We're going to Breakout Music Festival to see all the dopest artists. Yeah, so, Five Head Gang. All right, Five Head Gang, how's that name? Five Head Gang, is that cool? I was kind of thinking like, cause a lot of people have their like gangs out here. Like Fat Boy's got like Fat Boy Gang, and like Ugly God's got like the Lil Dick Gang. So I'm like, fuck, what about like Five Head Gang, man? I'm like the king of the five heads, so I might as well. I don't know. We'll see if you guys think about it. Anyways, we'll head in there right now.
Hey, bro. This guy wants to be in the vlog. What's your Instagram?
Young Avenue.
Do you want followers or what?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. That's good, bro.
Breakout.
You want a breakout, eh?
Breakout. Yep.
Oh, that's lit. Who are you excited to see?
Boogie.
A Boogie?
Yeah, and Juice Wrld.
And Juice Wrld, right?
Yeah.
Dude, Juice Wrld's crazy right now.
Yeah.
Bro, he's the guy.
That's sick, yo. Yeah, dude, Juice Wrld. I'm like super excited to see Juice Wrld. I honestly forgot about A Boogie, but you just reminded me. Yeah, A Boogie's gonna be sick.
Woo! All
right, dude.
You're the best. Cool. Make the best video.
Do you know, actually, bro? Do you know where the entrance is? Like, this is the entrance to go to Breakout?
Yeah.
Oh hell yeah, dude. That's hilarious, bro. I was about to go like all the way around that way.
Okay.
Let's go. Do you guys have the media passes?
No, you have to go to the PNE amphitheater, so you have to go all the way around.
Okay, gotcha. Apparently, we have to go to the other side, so I do actually have to walk all the way around there to go to the PNE amphitheater side, so that's where we're headed. Also, vlog. You know what I just realized is that I haven't showed you guys my new earrings, so I recently got my ears pierced. You know, little stud right there. What do you guys think? Look sexy? A lot of people think, like, because I'm black, I can pull it off, which I kind of agree, but I don't know if it looks a little sus, so let me know in the comments if you like the earrings.
What's good, bro?
Good, Johnny.
How you doing? I got a pass for you.
Oh, hell yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. So you're going to do some filming. I just want you, like, interviewing people and shit.
Yeah.
You know, just getting people's reaction and stuff.
Absolutely.
Yeah, 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 yeah. But I'll see you inside.
Okay, good
stuff. Yeah.
All right, sweet.
So, but you're good with that.
Okay, I can go anywhere with
this? Yeah.
Awesome, man. Boom, baby. We out here.
We out here. What is up, you guys? It's your boy Jonathan here, but you can call me Yanni. So we're here at Breakout Music Festival, and what we're going to be doing today is asking people some questions. We're going to find out who people are most interested in seeing. We're going to check out people's fits that they chose for this event. You know, we're going to see just what the vibe is right now. So we're going to ask them some questions. Stick around and check out this video. Let's go. Do you want to be my vlog? Real quick? Okay, I'm just asking you. Can I sit on this thing? Probably can, right?
This is my go-to pizza, bro.
You're a barbecue guy.
No, I'm a chicken and bacon guy, to be honest.
Chicken and bacon, oh, okay.
Chicken and bacon, man.
Damn, dude.
I want to ask both of you guys for a second. I got some fun questions. All right, so, do you guys know Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles?
Yeah.
All right, which Ninja Turtle do you guys relate with the most? You know,
Oh, like, my Donatello?
Donatello?
Yeah, 100%.
For sure? Donatello, yeah. Is that the leader? Is that the blue one?
No, no, he's the purple one.
He's the purple one.
Purple one.
Yeah.
Fuck are their names? I forgot their names.
There's the Donatello, Leonardo, Michelangelo.
Leonardo, bro. Raphael.
Raphael, he's the badass
Which
one.
One's the one with the fucking...
Leonardo. That's the leader.
Yeah.
Yeah. Leonardo. Yeah. Leonardo?
I'm Donatello, for sure.
Donatello?
Yeah, yeah. This is tech shit.
So purple and the blue one, right?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. That's
hype. That's vanilla gray colors.
Exactly.
All right, yo. If you guys had to pick five Pokemon to go fight the Elite Four, who's in your party? Who's your five Pokemon? Five Pokemon.
Bro, I gotta rock with Charizard.
Mm-hmm.
I gotta rock with Lugia.
Lugia. Oh,
Lugia is a wild one.
Yeah, yeah.
Mewtwo, if I get lucky and I catch it.
Oh yeah,
Pikachu. Mm-hmm. Gotta rock with him and Blastoise.
All
five.
Oh,
it's
let's
done,
get
bro.
It. Yeah. Let's get it.
Probably the same.
Same.
I mean, that's a solid. That covers most elements.
Oh, exactly. That's what I'm saying. You gotta be strategic. You gotta be
exactly,
smart.
Bro. It's all strategy. All right, good shit, yo. Hey. So, what time are you guys on at?
4:20.
4:20?
Blaze
oh,
it.
Of course. 4:20, blaze it.
Okay.
Yo, that's fire, yo.
We got Manila Gray out here, exclusive, man.
Okay. Which Ninja Turtle do you relate with the most?
Did you ever watch the Ninja Turtles?
My nigga Michelangelo. Bro.
Michelangelo?
The pizza guy? The orange dude? Always like cracking jokes and stuff?
Yeah, he be turned up, bro.
Yeah.
Funny too.
Yeah, dude. I fuck with Michelangelo. I feel like that's me too.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah.
Is,
did you ever play Pokemon growing up?
What?
Did you ever play Pokemon growing up?
Nah, I never did. I never got into it, bro. My brother and them, they was into it.
You never got into it? Oh. You know what's funny? It's like, I think Pokemon is sort of something that's like for older generations at this point. What about like, do you watch anime and shit?
Nah, bro. My cousin's into that, bro.
Your cousin's into that?
Yeah, see me, bro. I don't know.
See, you're too cool. You're like so cool, man. You're not a nerd like most other.
Nah,
like
it
most of
even,
us.
It wasn't even that. Yeah. I don't know. Like, I was just more outside, bro. I wasn't really watching TV and stuff like that.
What were you like? Like, do you have a bike and shit? Like, you like go outside?
Yeah. Like, trying to make money, bro. That's
trying to make money?
Yeah.
God damn, dude. That's legit. That's like, what's his face? My boy Smokey Marshall. Like, he's always talking about like the streets of New York. It's just like. Everybody's just like on a different wave, like everybody's just trying to make money and like grind and shit like that. What do you know about like the law of attraction and shit?
I know a lot about I don't know a lot about it, but I know that shit real, whatever. To me it feel real.
Yeah.
What's it called? Like just like this, bro. Last year I told DJ Jarrell that I was gonna perform with them next time they come.
Oh, for real?
Yeah, I just said it. I was just saying it.
Yeah.
And 1 year later I'm performing with them tomorrow.
So 1 year later, just like that.
Yeah, bro.
Like, I feel like of all the local artists, you're kind of blowing up the fastest.
Yeah,
like,
bro.
Your uprising is just like, it's like way, like a lot of these other guys have been grinding for a minute, but like you're like really moving.
Yeah, but I don't know. I just see it. I know exactly what to do and how to do it, when to do it. Like, I don't know. That's just how it feels. And it just ends up working the right way.
You just say it and it kind of like comes into reality. It speaks like
I say it and then I say it and I work for it.
Yeah.
I don't just say it. I say it and I work for it.
Yeah. That's the shit. Yeah, a lot of people say it and then they like don't do shit about it, right?
Yeah, like I work for it, but I don't go overboard. Like I don't do things that I don't have to do.
Mm.
It's either like I'm gonna do what I know I should be doing.
Yeah.
And hopefully, like not even hopefully, like I know it's gonna work. Like,
yeah.
Yeah.
Like, did your parents, like, instill that in you, or did you just kind of, like, growing up, or you just kind of, like, been born
like
that?
Yeah, that too, like, my mama and them, they raised me straight,
Yeah.
And then my brothers, too. Like, it's just like, you go for it, you feel me? Just, you do it, and the worst thing anybody can do is say no.
Exactly, bro. Like, why be afraid of, like, asking people for shit, like, the worst they can say is no, getting shut down, like, fuck it.
Exactly, and I'm like, we ain't scared of nobody saying no.
Yeah.
Like, it is what it is.
Yeah. Just do it, and also fuck haters too.
Exactly. Bro. Like, I don't know. I don't even be feeling haters, bro. Like,
bro,
like I know it's haters and stuff, but like we don't be worried about them at all.
Nah, you don't even waste time thinking about them.
Straight up.
Bro, anybody who's really putting themselves out there, like exposing themselves, like you're gonna be like faced with haters, like. Because like a lot of people, when they see you succeed, like they get jealous and shit, right? Like it's just natural. Like it's funny, man. I remember telling this one girl, I'm like, I'm gonna do this. I want to like make money, be an entrepreneur. And she got so defensive. Like, she acted like I was like saying something insulting to her. But she knows like psychologically, she knows that like I'm bringing out inside of her like some insecurities because she's got like insecurities about like not following her dreams and shit.
Exactly. That's right? Wild. That's. So when they say that, oh God, it's low key hating.
It's low key hating. Big facts.
fuck with you so hard.
Can I ask you a question in my video? Thanks, bro. It's funny, man. I was vlogging earlier today. I was just like, you're like the 1% I really wanted to see today. Yeah, fuck with it hard. But yeah. But yeah, bro, I wanted to ask you about your album because, like, first off, like, I think it's one of the best albums I heard this whole year. Wow. And, like, one of the things I loved about it, like, even more than the Ye album, man, facts, but, like, I like how you did the skits thing. Like, you put the, it's like a story, right? And it reminds me of, like, Good Kid, Mad City, too.
Yeah, yeah.
And, like, you get so engaged in the album because of that, because it's got, like, the whole storyline that you follow with.
Yeah.
But I want to ask you, like, was it based on, like, a real, like, real relationship? Like, was that that girl that was, like, talking there? Is that, like, real facts? Because, like, I'm like, damn, dude, that's a crazy bitch, man. Like, I'm, that'd be crazy. That, or is that kind of, like, is it kind of, like, artistic style type thing where?
Well, to answer that in the best way possible.
Yeah.
I would like to say that all the, that album, the emotions that came from me on that album.
Yeah.
Are based off of real situations.
Yeah.
I kind of blended a lot of negative situations together into one piece of art.
Yeah.
For the people that know me personally, they know more about the, you know, more.
They
about
know. They know the whole story because you've been talking to them, right? Yeah. Straight.
So they were there with me.
Yeah.
You know, for those that don't know me personally, they just know it's a, you know, it's the it feels too authentic to be made up.
Exactly.
So.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was based on a bunch of just molded together, you know, exactly. Negative situations. Whether it be stuff that I went through,
yeah.
My friends watched me go through, or yeah. Stuff I watched my friends go through.
Yeah, got you. I feel like you can't really make an album like that without experiencing it in some sort of way, like to create that sort of emotion.
Yes, that's true.
Like, especially since you write your own shit and stuff, right? Like, it's just, like, impossible to really do that.
Oh, yeah, I freestyle.
Yeah, you freestyle?
Yeah.
Dude, that, you freestyle the album? It looks, it's so deep.
Most of the songs. Well,
most of the songs?
I wrote Lucid Dreams. I freestyle all girls. Yeah.
Oh, my God, bro. That's fucking sick. Okay, yo, now just, I got some, like, kind of funny questions, but, like, did you ever watch, like, Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles growing up? Okay, like, which Ninja Turtle do you say you, like, relate with the most? Like, there's, like, Michelangelo, Leonardo, like, Donatello.
Mike.
Mike?
The, Nunchucks, right?
The, Mike. Yeah, yeah, the orange guy.
Because I'm silly.
Yes, yeah.
Like pizza, too.
Dude, I like, dude, that's, like, exactly the same as me, bro. I, yeah. And then, did you ever play Pokemon growing up? Yeah?
Sapphire.
Sapphire? So, like, what five Pokemon would be in your party if you're going to fight the Elite Four?
Mew, Mesprit, Infernape.
Infernape, let's go.
Rayquaza.
Rayquaza, yeah.
Giratina.
Giratina. Dude, you got the Lake the Legendaries, eh?
Mm-hmm, for sure.
Yo, let's go, bro. All right,
you remind me of my friend Jay so much, that's funny.
Oh, for real?
Yeah.
Oh, sick, man. Is he a YouTuber, too?
No, y'all just resemble each other. Like,
oh,
y'all
for real?
Be cousins. Funny.
Does he got a five head like me?
Funny, y'all got the same complexion. Y'all just kind of look alike.
Maybe he's a Habesha. Maybe he's like Eritrean, Ethiopian,
maybe
Somalian, something like that. That's cool, bro. Anyways, bro, I appreciate you so much, man.
You,
yeah.
Be right back up
Gross.
Shout out Trippy, man.
Sosa.
Yo, love Sosa. We got Juice Wrld.
What's up, guys? So I just wanted to add a little bit more footage to the end of this vlog, just give you guys a recap of my experience with Juice Wrld. So dude, it was sick because I said at the beginning that I really wanted to meet him, so it was really cool. And I think because I said that, like, gave me the balls to go approach him and like talk to him and stuff. But the guy is really chill, really cool. He's one of the, I'm gonna add him to my friendly celebrities list, you know, there's like, because a lot of the time celebrities just are like dicks, you know, like it's pretty frequently. But he's very similar to, I think, what most people would assume he'd be like from listening to his album. Like, he's a quiet guy. His voice is not that loud, and he's just chill. And something I actually wanted to tell you guys is that when I was talking to him, what he said was that, like, you know, he's grateful for all his success. Like, he thanks God. Like, he's happy that he has all the success now. But what he misses is the struggle. He misses the grind. He misses people being like genuinely wanting him to succeed and like pushing him forward and things like that. Where now it's like, you know, people are fake, and now he doesn't like get that grind feeling as much, you know. Yeah, and I feel like that feeling kind of comes from when you have a goal in mind and you're trying to achieve something, but oftentimes, like, once you've achieved that goal, I guess there's like an empty spot where that goal was now, and you got to find something else to motivate you to go forward. I mean, if I would say anything, my advice to him would just be create a new goal, like create a new desire. I mean, like, he still hasn't achieved, there's still lots more he can achieve in the whole music industry, like winning a Grammy and things like that. Yeah, that kind of felt like a little sad to me to hear him say that. I was like, damn, yo. It's crazy, man. It's like all the artists I really like always seem like a little depressed or something, or just very emotional. But which is, I think that's why we like artists, because they express something that oftentimes we don't express ourselves, or afraid to, or we just don't give ourselves time to like think as deeply as they do.
I feel like that's the purpose of artists, is to really express how the majority of people feel through their music, and then like then you relate with it. But yeah, I don't know, I feel like I could be his friend. Like I felt like we were like, I liked being around him, like it was cool, and I feel like he could be my friend. But yeah, that was cool, man. I was so sick meeting Juice Wrld, because like I just really appreciate him, really appreciate him. Anyways, guys, thanks for watching this video. Please like and subscribe. I know, like, because this video is pretty clickbait, well, it's not clickbaity, but it's like, it's kind of like one of those random videos you get that like maybe a lot of people will view, but like they might view it and they might not actually like check out my page. But you know, I just like check out, I don't know, if you like my videos, subscribe to me. Like I make dope content like this, and I'm from Vancouver and nobody else is really doing this in Vancouver, so there's, you could like see that. But yo, I encourage you, if you like, be dope if you just subscribe, you know. But I know how it is, because like I click on a video and I just click away and don't really think of it too much. I honestly skim through videos too. I don't even watch the whole video, so I understand people ain't really fucking with it like that. But yo, that's about it. Let's get this video uploaded. Thanks for watching, y'all. And now it's Sunday, so it's day 2. I'm about to go do this whole thing again. Let's get it. All right, peace.